Now we will solve some numericals related to psychometry chart. And here is the statement. With the help of psychometry chart, find properties of air if air is at 26 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Find dew point temperature, wet bulb temperature, specific volume of air, enthalpy of air and specific humidity of air. Here also we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So let's see how it is done. First we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data is air at 26 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. So I have taken psychometric chart. So what we have to do, first we have to see here, we have to get dry bulb temperature 26 degree Celsius. So 26 degree Celsius DPT line, we have to just take it till it meet the curve at relative humidity 60%. And once it is plotted, then we extend this line, we got dew point temperature is 15.8 degree Celsius. And we extend this line to the right side, then specific humidity we got as 0.0125 kilojoule per kg of dry air. And when we saw the specific volume lines, which is like this, so here we got somewhat near to 0.864 meter cube per kg specific volume. And this inclined line is specific enthalpy line, which we got as 65.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. So in this way, with the help of psychometric chart, we can determine different properties of air at 26 degree dry bulb temperature and 60% relative humidity. Now the next numerical is, in winter AC air conditioning system, 100 meter of air per minute at 15 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 80% relative humidity is heated until its dry bulb temperature is 22 degree Celsius with constant specific humidity. Find heat added to the air per minute. So here we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So first we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data for properties of air at initial condition is dry bulb temperature 15 degree Celsius and relative humidity 80%. And volume of air is 100 meter cube per minute. And the properties of air at final condition, dry bulb temperature 22 degree Celsius. As we can see that, dry bulb temperature has been increased from 15 degree Celsius to 22 degree Celsius from initial to final condition. So here we have to first mark initial and final condition on psychometric chart. And once it is plotted, we saw the specific enthalpy line which are inclined. So here we got H1 somewhat near to 36.5 kilojoule per kg. And for final condition, that is 22 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature, we got H2 is 44 kilojoule per kg. And there is another inclined line which is specific volume line for initial condition. And it is 0.8274 meter cube per kg. Now with the help of given data, that is volume of air at initial condition which is 100 meter cube per minute and specific volume which is 0.8274 meter cube per kg, we calculate mass of air. Now with the help of mass of air and difference of enthalpies of initial and final condition, we calculate heat added to air per minute, that is 906.4539 kilojoule. Now we are going to the next numerical. The following data refers to an air conditioning plant, cooling load 60 tons. The desired room condition is 27 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 55% relative humidity. And supply air condition is 17 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 15 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. Find sensible heat factor. So here we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So let's see how it is done. First we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data for properties of air at initial condition is 17 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 15 degree Celsius wet bulb temperature. And properties of air at final condition is 27 degree Celsius dry bulb temperature and 55% relative humidity. As you can see here, dry bulb temperature has been increased from 17 degree Celsius to 27 degree Celsius from initial to final condition. So now we have the process 1 to 2. And in the problem, we want to find out sensible heat factor. So sensible heat factor is the ratio of sensible heat to total heat. And total heat is the sum of sensible heat and latent heat. So in order to calculate sensible heat and latent heat, first we need to calculate enthalpies during process 1 to 2. Now here difference of enthalpies between point 1 to A is the sensible heat and difference of enthalpies between point 2 to A is latent heat. So put the values of H1, H2, H3 in the formula and calculate sensible heat factor. So we got sensible heat factor as 0.6. So in this way, with the help of psychometric chart, we plot the process and we got sensible heat factor. Now the next numerical is, Air is supplied to a conditioned room at 17 degrees Celsius drywall temperature and 50% relative humidity. The air leaves the room at 25 degrees Celsius drywall temperature, during which relative humidity decreases by 5%. Find dew point temperature of supply air, change in enthalpy during the process, change in specific humidity during the process, and show it on psychometric chart. So here we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So first we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data for properties of air at initial condition is 17 degrees Celsius drywall temperature and 50% relative humidity. And for final condition, it is 25 degrees Celsius drywall temperature and relative humidity decreases by 5%, that is 45% relative humidity. So as you can see, drywall temperature has been increased from 17 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius from initial to final condition. So here we have to first mark initial and final condition on psychometric chart. Now we have the process 1 to 2, and in the problem first we want to find out dew point temperature of supplier. So at point 1 the dew point temperature is 5 degrees Celsius. Now the next we want to find out change in enthalpy during the process. So enthalpy at point 2, which is H2, has 53 kilojoule per kg, and enthalpy at point 2, which is H1, has 33 kilojoule per kg. So from the difference of enthalpies, we got change in enthalpy of the process 1 to 2. And in same way, we want to calculate change in specific humidity during the process 1 to 2. So here specific humidity for initial condition, that is at point 1, which is W1, is equal to 0.0005 kg per kg of dry air. And for final condition, the specific humidity, which is W2, is equal to 0.009 kg per kg of dry air. So from W1 and W2, we got change in specific humidity during the process 1 to 2. So in this way, with the help of psychometric chart, we plot the process as per given data and we calculate different properties of air during the process. Now in the next problem, air at 25 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature and 25% relative humidity is to be conditioned to 22 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature, and specific humidity is 11 gram per kg of dry air. Determine heat transfer per kg of dry air referring to psychometric chart. Represent the process on psychometric chart by sketch. So here we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So first we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data for properties of air at initial condition is 25 degrees Celsius wet bulb temperature and 25% relative humidity. And for properties of air at final condition is 22 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and specific humidity 11 gram per kg. Now we have the process 1 to 2 and we want to determine heat transfer during the process 1 to 2. So in order to calculate change in heat, we need to find out enthalpies at point 1 and point 2. So enthalpies at initial condition, that is at point 1, is 77.5 kilojoule per kg, and at final condition, that is at point 2, the enthalpy is 49 kilojoule per kg. And putting values of H1 and H2, we got the heat transfer per kg of dry air as 28.5 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Now for the next numerical, the statement is, with the help of psychometric chart, find properties of air if air is at 24 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 40% relative humidity. Find dew point temperature, wet bulb temperature, specific volume of air, enthalpy of air and specific humidity of air. Here we have to plot the process on psychometric chart. So first we will write down the data which has been provided. The given data is air at 24 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 40% relative humidity. And once it is plotted, then we extend this line, we got dew point temperature as 8.7 degrees Celsius. And when we extend this to the right side, then specific humidity we got as 0.0065 kilojoule per kg of dry air. And when we saw the specific volume line, then we got somewhat near to 0.85 meter cube per kg of specific volume. And here the inclined line is specific enthalpy line. So in this way, with the help of psychometric chart, we can determine different properties of air at 24 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 40% relative humidity. Now for the next numerical, the statement is, atmospheric air at dry bulb temperature of 16 degrees Celsius and 25% relative humidity passes through a humidifier in such a way that Final dry bulb temperature is 30 degrees Celsius and 50% relative humidity. Find heat added to the air, moisture added to the air, sensible heat factor of the process. So here first we will write down the data which has been provided. So the given data for properties of air at initial condition is 16 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 25% relative humidity, and for properties of air at final condition is 30 degrees Celsius dry bulb temperature and 50% relative humidity. Now we have the process 1 to 2, that is initial to final condition. So here first we have to find out heat added to the air. For that we need to calculate change in enthalpy. So from psychometric chart, the enthalpy at point 1 is 23 kJ per kg of dry air, and at point 2 enthalpy is 64 kJ per kg of dry air. So put these values and we got heat added to the air as 41 kJ per kg. Now next we want to find out moisture added to the air, that is W1 minus W2, and the values of W1 and W2 we will get from psychometric chart, and put the values in equation and we got moisture added to the air as 0.0106 kg per kg of dry air. Now the third thing we have to find out is sensible heat factor. So sensible heat factor is the ratio of sensible heat to total heat, and total heat is the sum of sensible heat and latent heat. So in order to calculate sensible heat and latent heat, first we need to calculate enthalpies during the process 1 to 2. Now here the difference of enthalpies between point 1 to A is sensible heat, and difference of enthalpies between point 2 to A is latent heat. So put the values of H1, H2, H3 in formula and calculate sensible heat factor. So we got sensible heat factor as 0.366. So in this way, with the help of psychometric chart, we plot the process and we got sensible heat factor for the process. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with IF Infotech and do subscribe our channel IF Infotech.